When Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam was declared by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and obviously the Prophet had been instructed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do so, he was chosen by the Prophet to be his successor and to be the leader of the Muslim community after the Prophet. Basically, the Prophet in his speech in the day of Al-Ghadir, he granted Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam the same amount of authority that God gave him. God gave the Prophet. What he says, man kuntu mawlah, fahada aliyun mawlah. Whoever I am, his leader, his imam, his mawla, his master, Ali is his imam and his leader. By this, Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib was chosen as the leader of the community, the Muslim community after the Prophet, simply because Ali ibn Abi Talib has the closest personality to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. No one else can match the qualities of Ali ibn Abi Talib. No one else can be as close as to the Prophet like Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. In his knowledge, he was the most knowledgeable one, to the point that the Prophet calls him the gate of my city. Ana madinatul ilm, I'm the city of knowledge. Wa aliyun babuha, Ali is the gate to that city. In his piety, in his integrity, in his courage and bravery, in his generosity and sacrifices, no one else can match Ali ibn Abi Talib. That's why he is the most qualified individual to be the successor of the Prophet, simply because he represents the genuine qualities of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. In one hadith, the Prophet says to Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, Ya ana wa Ali, khuliqna min tinatin wahida, wa khuliqan nasu kulluhum min tinatin shatta. Me and Ali have been made of the same material, while other people were made out of different material. What does that mean? That the qualities of Ali are the closest to me. No one can even come close to the Prophet and his qualities other than Ali ibn Abi Talib. In another hadith, the Prophet says, Ana wa Ali abawa hadhihi al-umma. Me and Ali ibn Abi Talib are the parents of this ummah. We are the guardians. Because we all know that if it was not for Ali ibn Abi Talib and his sacrifices, Islam could not have taken shape. So that's why Ali ibn Abi Talib was chosen by Allah to be the successor of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, there are a few other subjects that I would like to touch upon really quick, and then